Hello grade 8. Welcome back to my channel. This is your teacher in PE, Ma'am Reina. For today's lesson, we will be talking about the game, chess. You are expected to do the following. Discuss the nature and background of the game chess. Explain the benefits that can be derived from playing chess. And apply rules and regulations and strategies in playing chess. Before we proceed, let us play a short game. Guess the word on each item. You have 5 seconds to answer. King. Check. Queen. Check again. That is right. Knight. Bishop. You're good. Rook. Correct. And for the last word. Pawn. Correct again. Great job. Now let's talk about chess. Chess is a board game for 2 players, each beginning with 16 pieces of 6 kinds that are moved accordingly to individual rules, with the objective of checkmating the opposing king. A brief history of chess. Most historians agree that the game of chess was first played in northern India during the Gupta Empire in the 6th century AD. This early type of chess was known as chaturanga, a Sanskrit word for the military. The Gupta chess pieces were divided like their military into the infantry, cavalry, elephants, and chariots. In time, these pieces became the pawn, knight, bishop, and rook. The English words chess and check both come from the Persian word shah, meaning king. The earliest written evidence of chess is found in 3 romances written in Sassanid Persia around 600 AD. The game was known as chaturang or shatranj. When Persia was taken over by Muslims, 633 to 644, the game was spread to all parts of the Muslim world. Muslim traders carried the game to Russia and to Western Europe. By the year 1000, it had spread all over Europe. In the 13th century, a Spanish manuscript called Libro de los Juegos describes the games of shatranj, chess, backgammon, and dice. The game changed greatly between about 1470 to 1495. The rules of the older game were changed in the West so that some of the pieces, queen, bishop, had more scope, development of the pieces was faster, and the game more exciting. The new game formed the basis of modern international chess. Historians of chess consider this as the most important change since the game was invented. 10 benefits in playing chess. It brings people together. It teaches you how to win and lose. It helps children. It can help you focus. It will serve as an educational tool. It develops one's creativity, builds confidence, develops problem-solving skills, exercises the brain, and helps you being calm. Game setup. Chess is played on a square board divided into 8 rows of squares called ranks and 8 columns called files, with a dark square in each player's lower left corner. This is altogether 64 squares. The colors of the squares are laid out in a checker pattern in light and dark squares. To make speaking and writing about chess easy, each square has a name. Each rank has a number from 1 to 8. And each file a letter from A to H. This means that every square on the board has its own label, such as G1 or F5. The pieces are in white and black sets. The players are called white and black, and at the start of a game each player has 16 pieces. The 16 pieces are 8 pawns, 2 rooks, 1 king, 1 queen, 2 bishops, and 2 knights. Rook. The rook may move forward, backward, and to the sides. The rook are particularly powerful pieces when they are protecting each other and working together. Bishop. It can move as far as it wants, but only diagonally. Each bishop starts on one color, light or dark, and must always stay on that color. They can capture an opponent's piece standing on their way by stopping on that piece's square. Knight. The knight moves by going 2 squares in one direction, and the one more move just like an L. It's the only piece that can move over other pieces. It can capture a piece, only when they land on that piece's square. Pawn. Pawn moves forward, but captures diagonally. It can never move backwards. On its first move, the pawn can advance 2 squares at a time. Queen. The queen is the most powerful piece. It moves in any one straight direction. Forward, backward, sideways or diagonal. The rook and bishop combined. King. The king is the most important chess piece. However, it is also considered one of the weakest. If you lose the king, you lose the game. You need to protect him at all costs. Terms to remember in playing chess. Castling. A move of a king and, or either a rook of the same color along the player's first draw. On the player's turn, he may move his king 2 squares over to one side and then move the rook from that side's corner on the square next to the king. Remember that there can't be any pieces between the rook and the king. The king should not be in check. Check. The result of a move that places the opposing king under an immediate threat of capture by one, or sometimes, two of the opponent's pieces. This means that you should have one of your pieces within capturing range of your rival's king. You will say check to let your opponent move their king to any free square, blocking the check, or capturing your piece that has placed their king in check. Checkmate. A situation in which one player's king is threatened with capture, in check, having no move to avoid that threat, thus, ending the game. The more of your opponent's pieces to capture, the easier it will be to checkmate. Your king should be properly protected at all times, so that your opponent can't get to him. Draw. A chess game where nobody ends a winner. A game may end in a draw at any time if one player offers a draw and the other accepts. If the exactly same position is repeated 3 times during a game with the same player to move each time, the player next to move may claim a draw. En passant. A special pawn capture which can occur immediately after a player moves a pawn 2 square forward from its starting position and an enemy pawn could have captured it had it moved only 1 square forward. Promotion. A special ability of a pawn wherein if it reaches the last row of the other side of the board, it can become any other chess piece except the king. If the pawn reaches the far side of the board, it must immediately be promoted to any other piece, except for the king. The best way is to promote your pawn to the queen. Touch and move law. If players wish to adjust a piece on the board, they must first say, "Je doube, I adjust," or the equivalent. Apart from that, if a piece is touched it must be moved if possible. If no legal move is possible with the touched piece, the player must make a legal move with another piece. When a player's hand leaves a piece after moving it then the move is over and may not be changed. Chess clocks. Competitive games of chess must be played with special chess clocks which time a player only when it is his or her turn to move. The essence is that a player has to make a certain number of moves in a certain total time. After moving, the player presses a button on the clock. This stops the player's clock, and starts the opponent's clock. There you have it. In the comments section, write at least one benefit in playing chess. I will give you 20 seconds to type your answer. Now let us answer the next exercise. Grab a paper and pen. Choose the best answer by writing the letters only. Great job. Impressive. You did well. Now that you know how to play chess, you can now play the game with your family and friends. If you do not have a chessboard at home, you may use the following smartphone app or any available platforms in the internet, using your personal computer or smartphone. Thank you for watching. Please hit the like button if you learned something about chess. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the notification bell. Once again, this is your teacher, Ma'am Reina. See you on our next episode. Have a nice day. Goodbye.